Subscribe for the very latest.
Bye, Daddy.
Courtroom. More than a podcast.
But you know, Patrick, back to Patrick Ewing, legendary, like I said. Now, what I admire, so remember, so getting back to a sneaker, did he sign with Adidas first?
I think he signed with Adidas first. Patrick Ewing did have like a deal with him, but he didn't have a signature. I don't think he had a signature with Adidas. And the thing is, like, Dikembe Mutombo had a signature with Adidas, but Patrick Ewing didn't have a signature, and that's the thing that makes the Ewing so good. I don't know if he was about to say this, like if he was about to
but
Patrick Ewing had one of the hottest sneakers in the 90s with no major label back. That's what I'm saying.
Right.
Nike, no Adidas, no Reebok. This man had one of the hottest sneakers and in the market. And I'm saying, I bought me a pair of Ewings. Like I bought me some off of Fight Club. Them joints cost me 200 bones, but them joints was fly. And his sneaker is definitely like one of the best, one of the coldest ones. Like, and it is still hot to this day. Like,
right.
Mostly Knicks fans or New Yorkers wear them, but like when people see them, like they're very much a staple sneaker. Like, and that's one of the things that like you can tell when it comes to marketability, because it was very well designed. It's a very nice, slick looking sneaker. But outside of that, like, David Robinson was signed with Nike. No, Michael Diggs. Hakeem Olajuwon didn't have a major sneaker label, but he was signed with Spalding. So, like, Spalding made his sneaker. And as far as Shaq, you know, Shaq was with Reebok. And who am I missing as far as bigs? I think I named
it. Centers or power forwards?
I mean, centers. We can say power forwards, too. But, I mean, Charles Barkley, we know he was with Nike. Sean Kemp, he was with Reebok. But Patrick Ewing is not with a major label. It's Patrick Ewing's shoe. And it was selling like it was with a major label. Yeah, he played for the Knicks, but like he was killing for the Knicks. Nice. Like he was marketable. Like they was able to actually use that and push that. And like him versus Eric, like, bro, that's something that no one else really has that I have yet to see.
Right.
Since a Patrick Ewing.
Well, in the United States, because you know, I think Starbury's still killing them over there in China.
We ain't wearing them over here.
I'm sorry, Starbury.
Do they look that bad?
You can't play two games in them. That's what's wrong.
Nah. Wow. They got remember when Inspector Gadget was like, this message is going to self-destruct. Soon as you read it, soon as you put them sneakers on, they want self-destruct.
You can't do a suicide. You can't do a defensive slide. Nah. You can't do none of that.
Anything that requires agility or change of direction.
Right.
It's no go.
Right. Wow. Hey, Walt, it is suicide to play them.
Straight up.
For your ankles, knees.
Right.
I'm saying, man. It was worth all $15. I'm telling you that right now.
Yeah, I understand what you were doing, but that's Jazz Citizen. I understand what you were doing, Starberry, but it's a no go, man. But I'm gonna tell you though, Ewing. Do you know how much money he was making per year? How much do Ewing? $40 million a year in the '90s. $40 million.
That's Jordan money right there, bro.
Factual. That sneaker represents what black buying power really is. Right? I'm 8 years old when these sneakers come out. Because I think it came out in 88. They really, really started hitting in the '90s though. When they got the distribution deal. Now I'm like 10 years old, so I still don't understand, but I think somewhere in there, the reason why they were so popular was because I think one they dope. We're not gonna wear none that's whack, right? Okay. But I think also it's the fact that he was independent, a black man.
I like that. Like much better.
You know,
he was independent.
Yeah, owning his own shoe, designing his own shoe. Now, I think around, maybe 92, somewhere in there, 93, they faded out, somewhere in there. But they came back.
Question, my bad. I didn't mean to cut you, man. When did they,
now you good?
Like, what year did they come back? Like, just because, like, now, I see them like regular, like they're all on social media with the advertisements. So what year did they just come back into
they came back in 2012. Presence. They came back in 2012. Nice. Now I was looking for them. Like I was looking for them, you know, and I was so glad to see they came back. Somebody named I think the name of the company is called GPF Footwear, bought them back. But the dope thing about them is that they stuck to the original design. Let me see if I can get to the site real quick. So they stuck to the original design,
nice,
of the shoe. Like this is all like the original. These are the ones I had.
That's the one I wanted. I wanted these so bad.
Yeah, I had those, but it was real suede. Like them joints is like
a friend of mine in fifth grade. A friend of mine he had some the suede ones looked just like that one, but they were like red or burgundy or something.
Right now, oh yeah, nah. These are the original. Those are the original ones. But you know, like I said, they stuck with the original. The original design of them. But they also started coming with like these. Let me show you. These are some of my. I think these are it right here. Are these the ones. See, like these are some of my favorite. Like these are the Ace Ventura joints. Mm-hmm. And you know, they got the, these are the Brooklyn Dodger joints. Ooh, these Brooklyn Dodger ones tight fire. I like the Ace Ventura joints too. You know, nice little ugly design, you know, little crazy design.
I think he's got like two or three major silhouettes, and then they go crazy on the colors. Like I had like a gray pair with like a black sole. Like that's the one that I had.
These are these right here? These are the original, the 33 highs?
Yeah. I had a 33 high.
Uh-huh.
And it was all gray, but the sole was black. That's the one that I had. I bought it off Flight Club. I'll never forget. I was like 21 years old. But I remember purchasing that thing. I wore them joints out.
Man, you love, and you know what? For you, because you have 14. Like they specialize in
big dudes. Yeah,
yeah, they specialize in that. So you know, you can get a nice, comfortable shoe. You know, if you got a big size foot, you can still get a nice, comfortable shoe because it's hard to find when you start getting those teens. Mm-hmm. You know. It's really hard. Now, the ones I showed you, I like the Rogues. Now, the dope thing, and they're not showing these, but I think I got one. Let me see if I can find it. Like this one right here. They did a lot of hip hop collaborations, right? Like this one right here is the Big L shoe. It's the Big L shoe. I like this Big L shoe. Nice little simple shoe. And then they got
what
Big
does the
L
top look like? They got the top. What the top look like?
Yeah, they don't show like the front, but that's the face of Big L on the tongue. His block. That's where he's from. Lenox Ave, 139 Lenox Ave. So they got that on the back. and you got these on the side. But yeah, this big L one is a very, very, I like this shoe. Now they got a couple of other ones that's not on here right now that I was trying to get, but like they got the salt and pepper ones. They got the AZ ones, was real, like, you know, hot in at one point. I'm trying to see if I can find, maybe they're in the clearance section, they're probably fading them out. Let's see if I can find this. Is it in here? Let's see. I don't see. They had the CNN ones, the Death Row ones. So what I'm trying to say is they stuck to the fan base. Are these the EPMD ones? Yeah, these the EPMD. I'm not really a big fan of the EPMD ones. Y'all can kind of look at them. I know what they tried to do. They tried to go with one of the album covers that they had and kept the same scheme of the album cover. I mean, you know, if I had them in a closet, I'd find something to wear with them. But I mean, this is what it looked like on somebody's foot. But you know, and see, and this is the album cover right here that they tried to stick with in the color scheme, right? Mm-hmm. But all in all, I like the rebranding when they came back and rebranded the you know, the shoe. I think that once again, another independent shoe. Well, the only independent shoe that I know of, right? Like I don't know no other independent shoe out there. I don't know nobody doing it big like Patrick Ewing's doing with the independent route, you know. And that's why I still buy Ewing. You know,
so that's what actually one of my questions is, like, what you guys do you guys still feel like the Ewings like you did back then, if you guys rock them still to this day?
Yeah, but just looking at the ones we saw,
that big L one, I would wear that right now. Like I would rock that out right now.
Ooh, did you see the gum bottom on that joint? Yeah. It had the clear gum bottom on.
Oh. I love gum bottoms on sneakers. I would wear those. I'd wear the OG ones that Tino had. The Georgetown ones. He has some nice Georgetown ones.
Yeah.
And of course, you know, I'm a Patrick Ewing fan. I'm a New York fan. Right. There's a strong, but that sneaker is very strong in New York. Like that,
it's the thousand, across the board though, for real.
Yes, yeah. I'm saying, like, in New York. That's what I'm just saying. Because you've seen the collabs with, like, a lot of New York staple in hip-hop, like you were saying. Like, if it wasn't Fly, they would not put Big L's name.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
So, that's a fact. And you know how New York is. I mean, everybody got their style, but we all know how we do up there. So, if you... The Ewings is a very, very big shoe in the game. We're not saying it's Jordan. It's not. It's Ewing. It's his own. So that's why it's a big way.
And I like the way they let the hip hop artists come in, pick whatever brand they want, like whatever design they want to get. Like, you know, like I said, they got the Rogue, they got the 33 highs, and it's another one that they normally pick. They let them come in, design their own shoe. They might get a couple of pieces of clothing with them, you know. AZ, I like AZ shoe. Pun shoe was okay. I see what they was trying to do with Pun shoe, but you know, all in all, CNN's was decent. But I just like the way that they give hip hop, you know, a space of, you know, true collaborations, not because for me sometimes. You know, I don't know. I could be wrong, but some of those other Jordan collaborations, they kind of bland. You know, like
OVOs.
Yeah, they you know, like the TS ones. I'm not really like. I just feel like they had a Jordan. They had a shoe. They just stitched TS on it. You know.
You know who
Squad.
You know who Ewing should try to make a sneaker, like do like another collab with. I think they should do something with Joey Badass. I feel like that would be fly.
That would be sick. Joey's a very fly individual. And he's a very fashion. Because he's not a big star like that. But Joey can really dress. If you really watch, him, throughout his career, he's a fly individual. So you're right. That would be really dope. To do it, especially now that he's coming back with Raising Kanan, which we'll talk about a little that in the future here. But yeah,
got a question.
What's up?
What if they did a Trump shoe?
Stop.
What? I mean, no. What if they had the colors, man? They had St. Patrick Ewing style, but
I cannot see all red shoe.
What, man? That's a legit question.
It's really it's really not a legit question.
Trim, you are banned from asking any more questions.
I'm about to mute him. I normally don't flex mute power. I normally don't, but I might have to.
That was wow.
He's on probation from asking it, until further notice with questions.
Hey, the man knew he knew Harry Tubman, man.
But anyway, stupid. shout out to Patrick Ewing, man. Patrick Ewing, listen, you didn't get a chip, but you know what? Sometimes in life we create our own chips, know. And sometimes we're known for other things other than what we originally, came in, our original passions. And I think that the Patrick Ewing shoe is a great representation of what all Black people should do. They should take their name and they should gamble on themselves and not go with the powers that be all the time. Go gamble. Patrick Ewing, think about it. Patrick Ewing when he first started that shoe, he was not a huge star.
Well, does he still own majority stake in the company now?
I don't know about that, but I do know I'm sure he gets something with his name on it. Like I don't think
because it's literally built off his name. Like
right,
yeah, it's just his name
for real. But like, I don't see how he isn't at least taking home at least 40% of it. Like
right,
it's
right.
Literally built off his name.
Yeah, nah. I'm gonna say yes. We'll do some more research on that. But but it's still a privately owned shoe.
It's a privately owned shoe.
Gamble, go. If you got a vision, build it, man. That's what Ewing did. It's a great representation of what a vision looks like and somebody betting on themselves. So shout out to Patrick Ewing. For betting on himself and the streets embracing the shoe still, because we listen, if it ain't Nike, really think about this. If it ain't Nike, if it wasn't Puma back then, I'm saying? Even brands like Etonic. Remember Etonic? Oh, yeah, Alesi's. There were some brands out there that was kind of like off a little bit. We're gonna talk about some of them brands. Etonics, it was a brand called Elise's. I want to say it was called Etavia, because Jim Jones wore them on a photo shoot he did in the Source magazine. I wonder if I can find this shoe. But Jim Jones and Mano a fashion shoe, and I saw the shoe. I'm like, yo, he really bought these back. Let me see if I can find it real quick before we move on. I don't know if I can find the picture, but I'm just like, yo, this is old school. Here's it. I know I see the photo, but they're not. I don't think they're gonna show the shoe. Here we go. I don't know if y'all probably can't see it though. It's probably too far away. It's too far away, man. But I'm gonna find that shoe. I'm gonna do a whole set on like all of these sneakers that weren't super popular, but we wore them. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like we wore them. But we gonna move on. Once again, shout out to Ewan holding it down.
Deep in the rap, graffiti, break dancing, DJ and B-boy stance, MCing. I harness those artifacts, collecting data of the transitions like an almanac. Hip hop ain't dead, these young boys different, adapting. Over time, every day the world's spinning. Let's celebrate the fact we still winning, we global. Kids from the project became moguls. Real to real track boards to Pro Tools, vinyls, cassettes, and the tape decks, CDs. Now you can stream your music to the consumer direct and get most of the check. I'm noble. And with that, I gotta respect that you ain't gotta accept that you can ride and get left, yo. Bars beyond ground level.